Okay, so a brief break from having to think about numbers. We're going to get back to that though, don't worry. We're going to talk about some considerations that we need to take when we are calculating things like yardage and how much to account for and stuff like that. So, I know this is everyone's favorite thing to talk about. And I know that everyone loves to hear it, but you should make samples. No one likes to spend money and time making something teeny tiny that just proves what you already know, or what you think you already know, just to do it really big later. But there is real merit in making a sample. I actually have some samples that I've made for this exercise that prove this really, really well, and why sampling is important, and why I just so wholeheartedly suggest it every time. The only way that you will ever know for absolute certain how something behaves when you weave it in a certain way, when you weave it in a certain dense size, when you weave it, with your particular beat style, when you finish it, how you want to finish it, whether you wash it or steam it or just give it a light hand wash or anything like that. The only way to know for sure exactly how something will turn out is to do it. There are things that you can get away with. The weaving police are not going to come after you if you don't make a sample. You can get away with not doing it, and it's okay. It's not against the law, and it's not against my moral code if you don't do it. It's just something really, truly, if you're planning a really big project, if you're planning something that's going to cost you a significant amount of money, especially, if it's something that you've never done before, but you want to make curtains for your house, that's a big project. If you want to make a rug for your floor, that's a big project. You want to make sure that your materials work out, that your experience works out, that you know how to handle it at the end of it, or that the way that you think you should handle it is the best way to handle it. The only way to know that for sure is by making a sample for yourself. You will never know otherwise. Maybe somebody you know did it before you, and that's okay. Just bear in mind that, like we're gonna see with my samples later, individual handling of things, the way that each of us do things, is so different from someone else. Even if you learn directly from them, the way that I do stuff, the way I tie knots, is different than how my mentor taught me, just by merit of the way that my hands work. So I know it seems like I'm a broken record. When you can, when you feel like you're not sure, when you're going to commit to something really big and expensive, make a sample first. All right, next thing that people don't like to think about is wasted warp. Please try not to think about loom waste, I know the words in there, don't think about that, as waste. It is imperative to have it. You cannot get away from it. It is something that you absolutely cannot get rid of, no matter how hard you try. Like I mentioned when we were talking about lingo, there are ways that you can minimize loom waste, and you can also put it to use in other things. So if you want to do fringe, like on a scarf or a shawl, this is perfect for that. You have all of this wasted warp at the end and the beginning that you can't deal with because it's how you tie on or something like that. If you have enough, then use it for your fringe. That's great. Just make sure that if you don't have enough, that you do spacers or something in the front, and then make sure that you leave enough in the back that you can get your fringe out of it. If you don't want to do fringe though, you're just going to have some at the end that isn't going to be woven. And that's okay. It is not wasted. It was a vital tool in getting you connected to your loom so that you can weave. So I know that the word waste is here. Try not to think about it as something that goes to waste. It is useful, and it is inevitable. Now, the way to consider loom waste for how to add on, you know, later, you know, if I have 15 inches in the back and 10 inches in the front together, that makes 25 inches. Do I just add 25 inches to my total yardage? No. You add that to the length part of our second equation. So once you have your number of ends, you multiply that by your length plus your loom waste, and then that will give you your total yardage. If you just add on 25 inches, you've added on enough loom waste for one single end in your project. And you can clearly see how that doesn't work out at the end. So make sure, if you have any number of loom waste at the end, if you have 25 inches, if you have 10 inches, if you have whatever, it will depend on you, it will depend on your loom, it will depend on how you warp as to how much you have. Make sure you add that into your length calculation in the second equation when you do that. Yeah, I think that's it.